السلام عليكم، شكرا جزيلا سيد الرئيس، واشكر الدكتور محمد صفحي والدكتور طارق الزياغاوي والدكتور محمود حسنين على دعوتي للمؤتمر الجميل ده. والحقيقه الدكتور طارق الزياغاوي سهل عليا الموضوع، وطبعا له شكر خاص تاني. نعم. مش زي والله. comorbidities in HFpEF. HFpEF is now the most common form of heart failure affecting around 3 million people in the United States. It's a traditional syndrome, as Dr. Tara said, one of the important phenotypes may be related to the comorbidities. Comorbidities are similar to three things: volume related or pulmonary related or some others. Volume related, they renal dysfunction, diabetes, hyponatremia, anemia, hypoalbuminemia. كل الحاجات دي بتعمل volume retention, fluid retention, obesity also, fluid retention. Pulmonary related, مكتوب بالاصفر, subclinical pulmonary dysfunction, obstructive sleep apnea, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Other etiologies or other factors like rheumatoid arthritis, peptic ulcer disease, and hypothyroidism. Bidirectional impact of on the disease progression. مع حضراتكم شايفين كده في اسهم يمين وشمال. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease في عندي سهم هنا. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease inflammation يكون مصحوب inflammation, hypoxia, parenchymal changes, airflow limitation, leading في الاخر الى pulmonary congestion. Abnormal left ventricular diastolic filling and also inhaled beta agonist. طبعا بيعمل tachycardia أو بيعمل arrhythmias that may further impair diastolic function. الاتجاه الثاني elevated end diastolic pressure and beta blockers that used for obstructive lung disease may impair diastolic function and further aggravate heart failure. Anemia, adverse left ventricular remodeling, adverse cardiorenal effects, increased neurohormonal and inflammatory cytokines that impair or aggravate heart failure. On the other hand, inflammation, hemodilution, renal dysfunction, metabolic abnormalities, excessive weight, anemia. يعني bidirectional effect. Diabetes also, diabetic cardiomyopathy, mitochondrial dysfunction, abnormal calcium handling, oxidative stress, renal angiotensin endothelial system activation, all these aggravate heart failure. On the other hand, there's that worse diabetes may occur due to the oxidative stress and inflammatory state present in this heart failure syndrome. Renal dysfunction, salt and water retention, anemia, associated renal dysfunction, inflammation, RAS and sympathetic system activation, aggravated heart failure. On the other hand, cardiorenal syndrome through low cardiac output, accelerated atherosclerosis, inflammation, increased venous pressure, impaired renal function further. Sleep disorders through hypoxia, systemic inflammation, systemic sympathetic activation, arrhythmias, hypertension, pulmonary and systemic occurs in sleep disorders. Right ventricular dysfunction worsening congestion. كل ده هيزود ال HFpEF. On the other hand, postural fluid retention, restoral fluid movements may worsen pharyngeal obstruction, more disturbance of pulmonary function. Obesity through inflammation, reduced physical activity, decongestion, deconditioning, hypertension, metabolic syndrome, diabetes mellitus, all these aggravate heart failure. On the other hand, fatigue, dyspnea, may limit activity, spectrum of metabolic disorders that associate to obesity may include further, obesity. Aging per se is a collection. A cocktail of comorbidities like coronary artery disease, diabetes, aortic stenosis, atrial fibrillation, all these are comorbid conditions for HFpEF. Different studies, a lot of studies for renal dysfunction. These studies, as you see, all these studies were done on renal dysfunction treating HFpEF. More than 50% of cases with HFpEF. Effect on outcome, worse of renal function, increased 1 year mortality, all cause mortality, and U shaped relationship with GFR. And with hyponatremia, all these studies from 12% up to 25% of cases were HFpEF. And the effect, as you see, hospital mortality, 1 year mortality increase. Hypoalbuminemia, these two studies, it's not sufficient for me in this case. 28% with this study, and this study here, LIO, 28% with HFpEF, the all-year mortality, all-cause mortality increased significantly. Anemia, these two studies, 10% cases with HFpEF, and increased all-cause mortality and cardiovascular mortality and hospital admission also increased. In these famous studies, Sharma trial, the outcome patients with HFpEF with and without diabetes. As you see, in patients with diabetes, the cardiovascular death hospitalization were nearly doubled. In the RELAX trial, the hospitalization, cardiac arrhythmia caused 6 months, were 4 times in patients with diabetes versus non-diabetes. Pathogenetic effects of comorbidities, effect on endothelial cells, and effects on cardiomyocytes. As you see here, the effect on endothelial cells is the microvascular inflammation and the endothelial activation. On cardiomyocytes, decreased cyclic GMP, tightened phosphorylation, microvascular ischemia, and concentric leakage. Titan, that is the third, the largest third factor موجود في السيل mitochondria بعد الأكتين والميوسين, and this is possible for vessel stiffness of the cell, prevents overstretching of the sarcomere. فده بيبقى activated في الحالة دي. Summary and conclusion, a paradigm of HFpEF supporting comorbidity-driven inflammation in systemic and cardiac microvascular dysfunction has been proposed. Comorbidities increase heterogeneity and complicates management of HFpEF, especially with beta agonist and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Comorbidities are associated with cardiac and non-cardiac worst outcome. Thank you very much.